be encouraging in that direction. Second Timothy 3:16, 17, so God, all scripture is God-breathed and useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. So the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. And I think that this has, I see this as a twofold, not just the physical parts, but also our mental, our thinking process. We're to be taught correct thinking, you know, be open to teaching and receiving correct thinking, rebuking. And I looked up the word rebuke, and that's to express sharp or stern disapproval of. So you want to have stern disapproval of negative thinking. You want to have corrective ways of changing that negative thinking to positive, and then be trained. So training is, you know, talking with other people, getting their viewpoints, their aspect on what you're thinking in the negative areas, and being a team, making a team effort. So God plants a thought, and then we act upon it. So we, in order for us to do something physical, we have to first think about it. That's the, you know, we got, you know, just this even simple thing, like going to the store, you think about it first, and you say, well, then you're going to go to the store. So it's not just something you do, but you have to think about it first.
Well, if you don't, then you better step your own way.
Yeah.
Think about it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And about that way, that's a good point.
Oh, well, yeah. Some people just want to go shop.
Yeah. Yeah, they just kill time, yeah. Yeah. Without thinking.
Without thinking.
So, little red wagon, what I've been hauling around, you know, and I was hauling around a lot of negative things, and I'd say that it's totally cleared out, like from the picture earlier. But a couple things, you know, I've taken and prayed about. One thing was despair. I had a lot of despair in my life. I replaced it with hope. Hope that who God is in my life and for a better future. I know He's got plans, and I'm open and willing to walk in those plans for Him. Another thing I had in my red wagon was self-pity. But I have gratefulness of who I am in Christ. It's not about me anymore. It's about Him and who I'm living for. So what's in your red wagon? I'm going to take a few minutes here to talk about this. So what are you pulling around your red wagon? What negative stuff? What trash do you need to get rid of? And what treasures can you replace them with? So let's take about 5 minutes. Get up and chat with somebody different.